Meanwhile, a boy in Turkey experienced something that a lot of us might have either experienced or been worried about. You're walking along distracted by your phone when disaster strikes, but a horrible outcome is narrowly averted. So don't get too scared, but let's jump into this video.
There's the boy walking. There he is, right? You see him? Then he's a little distracted. Why? Because he's on his phone. Right, but get this, he lands on a, did you see this? Wait, Nate, look at
this. Oh my God.
That's where he landed. He landed on a pile of boxes that kind of just, you see.
That's divine intervention.
Right? Really, instead of hurting himself, he landed on those boxes, as you can see.
Okay, that probably still hurt a little bit, but that could have gone way worse.
Nothing makes me laugh harder than somebody falling or like a very slow moving disaster. And I feel like I got both of those things there. So that's a great clip. What, oh my God. And also just, you know, look up when you're walking. I think that's good general advice for everyone, for all of us. You know?
Here's the thing. Like, we've all seen the videos like people falling in manhole covers. When you're in a building, you generally don't expect there to be holes in the ground.
Yeah, why is there?
Maybe they're transferring stuff through there. There's not a lot of information.
You'll be shocked to find out. Slash floor. Yeah.
Yeah. So they drop it.
Anything.
Yeah. It's like on a ship, basically. You have like the hole, so you can drop it down. Yeah. I love that the way that it ended. The only ways that it could have been better is one, and maybe we can show this video again. There is that pink bag of fluffy stuff. He really missed an opportunity to fall onto that. That might have been hilarious too. Maybe a little bit more painful. So maybe it's better. Come on, fall on the pink fluffy stuff. Ah. And if not that, the fact that he falls in the box, which then careens forward, if that had started a chain reaction of knocking down every pile of boxes in the room, that would have been better, but maybe he can make it happen next time. Anyway, glad that he got through safe. Anyway, sure. Meanwhile, in. Meanwhile, in China, in the Winter Olympics, something happened that allowed Vice to print the most Vice headline ever. This skier's penis almost froze mid-race at the Winter Olympics. It's apparently a real problem. It happened to a Finnish athlete, Remy Lindholm, who says, "You can guess which body part was a little bit frozen when I finished. It was one of the worst competitions I've been in. It was just about battling through." And it turns out that when you experience frostbite on the penis, it's not the frost that causes the pain. It's what comes after. When the body parts started to warm up after the finish, the pain was unbearable. And I can't even imagine, but I also don't do winter sports. I understand that they do a lot to like warm themselves up. They like do all this stuff to cover their face and everything. Like, maybe consider the other stuff too. There's gotta be some shorts you can wear, buddy.
I mean, he's from Finland. That? Isn't he better equipped to deal with freezing cold temperatures? And in China, didn't they had to use fake snow when even that cold and there wasn't enough snow there? I don't know, but it's funny because I did know that about frostbite. If you have frostbite, it's better to just keep packing it with snow because it hurts once it starts to defrost. I don't know what you do beyond that. I don't know if you just have to keep it frozen for the rest of your life or if there's like some kind of medical something. I don't know.
If you
I live in Texas, I don't know about frostbite.
You don't experience frostbite. If you start to experience frozen penis, track down Bubba Fett and do the frozen and carbonite thing. That is the only chance that you have until he gets you to Tatooine, I guess. But anyway, you're right. He's from Finland and they're better equipped to deal with the snow. He ended up getting through it. Maybe a regular someone not from Finland might have had a worse experience. There might have been a subtraction from their anatomy there. Anyway, Remy Lindholm's not the only person to have experienced this. Antarctic adventurer Alex Brazier also fell victim to the condition, known colloquially as polar penis, during an 1,100 mile trek back in 2016. He says it sounds hilarious, but it turns out incredibly unpleasant and really quite painful and cold. So suffering a bit this morning, he wrote in a blog post.
Is it like a full recovery though? Like do they get full functionality back?
I hope so. For their sake, yes.
It's unclear.
It's unclear. We're gonna do more research. So I did True North where I went to the Arctic. We have occasionally alluded to the possibility of doing True South. We are going to be doing way more research in advance of this documentary, it now turns out. Because there are some things I'm willing to sacrifice for the audience and some things I'm not.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.